Hello everyone, this is Anon from Anon Math Channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at a logarithmic problem. Basically, we're going to evaluate a log in terms of another log because we're given that log 27 with base 12 equals to a, and we're supposed to use this equation to evaluate log 16 with base 6. But first, let me review some basic important logarithmic properties that I'm going to use in this video, and then we're going to use them to solve this problem. The first and most important property that I'm going to use in this video is the change of base property, or the change of base formula. Basically, whenever we have log x with base y, we can rewrite it as log x over log y, and the base can be any positive number such as z, but usually we consider z as 10 because when the base is 10, we don't need to write it. The second property that I'm going to use is the power property. Whenever we have log of an exponent, such as x to the n, we can bring the power in front as the coefficient of log, and that means that log x to the n equals to n times log x. And the third property that I'm going to use in this video is the product property, which states that log mn with base b equals to log m with base b plus log n with base b. Basically, whenever we have log of a product, we can separate it into a sum of logs. Anyway, we're going to use these properties to solve our problem. So first we are given log 27 with base 12 equals to a, and by using the change of base property, we can say log 27 over log 12 equals to a, and then we can replace 27 with 3 cubed, and we can replace 12 with 2 squared times 3. We basically factor them. And then we use the power property on the top, and we get 3 log 3. And then by using the product property on the bottom, we get log 2 squared plus log 3, which again equals to a. And then by using the power property again, we get 3 log 3 over 2 log 2 plus log 3. And then we're going to cross and multiply. We get 3 log 3 equals to 2a log 2 plus a log 3. And then if you move this to the left hand side, we get 3 log 3 minus a log 3 equals to 2a log 2. And if we pull out log 3, we get log 3 times 3 minus a equals to 2a log 2. And then from this equation, we get something very nice. Log 3 over log 2 equals to 2a divided by 3 minus a. And this is a very important result from the given information. And I'm going to use this ratio to evaluate log 16 with base 6. So we want to evaluate log 16 with base 6. I'm going to rewrite it as log 16 over log 6 by using the change of base property. And then we can factor 16 as 2 to the 4th, and we can factor 6 as 2 times 3. And then by using the power property on the top, we get 4 times log 2. And by using the product property on the bottom, we get log 2 plus log 3. And this is great because we have everything in terms of log 2 and log 3. But the problem is, how can we use this ratio to evaluate this expression? Well, to do that, I'm going to do something very special. I'm going to divide everything, both the top and the bottom, by log 2. By doing that, we get something very nice. By doing that, we get 4 log 2 over log 2 divided by log 2 over log 2 plus log 3 over log 2. And since log 2 over log 2 cancels to 1, and we know the value of log 3 over log 2, this is going to be very nice. Basically, from this we can say log 16 with base 6 equals to 4 over 1 plus 2a over 3 minus a. And then to simplify this fraction, I'm going to multiply both the top and the bottom by 3 minus a. So we get 4 times 3 minus a divided by 3 minus a plus 2a, which simplifies to 12 minus 4a divided by a plus 3. And that means that we evaluated log 16 with base 6 in terms of a. And this brings us to the end of this video. As always, if you like this video, if you enjoyed watching it, click like, click subscribe, leave a comment, and share this video with your friends. Goodbye, and I will see you in another video.